गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल, दिस इज स्वप्ना। वेलकम टू एडवांस्ड न्यूरल नेटवर्क वीडियो। टुडेज आवर टॉपिक इज लर्निंग विदाउट ए टीचर। देयर आर टू लर्निंग पैराडाइम्स आर देयर। फर्स्ट वन इज लर्निंग विद ए टीचर, सेकंड वन इज ए लर्निंग विदाउट ए टीचर। सो सेकंड लर्निंग पैराडाइम इज आवर टुडेज टॉपिक, लर्निंग विदाउट ए टीचर। इन दैट आल्सो टू मेथड्स आर देयर। One is reinforcement learning or neurodynamic programming. Another one is unsupervised learning. So here we are starting with the reinforcement learning, neurodynamic programming. In this, it is shown in the black diagram how it is going to learn. So in this, it is having the environment which is having the training examples, and two components are mainly critic and learning system. So critic will take and learning system will take the input from the environment. It also takes the critic will take the primary reinforcement as well as it also take the state vectors, and whatever that examples are there, that one also given to the learning system. So here critic will take the primary reinforcement and the state vector from that. It will generate the heuristic reinforcement that is also given to the learning system. Learning system will get the input from the environment and this one heuristic reinforcement. From that it will generate the some it will discovers the better actions which are suitable for overall the system, which will give the better performance to the overall system. That is also once again given back to the environment, and step by step procedure will continue like this till we will get the exact learning. So it is learning of the input output mapping is performed through the continuous interaction with the environment in order to minimize the scalar index of the performance. In this system built around the critic is the main thing that converts the primary reinforcement signal received from the environment into the higher quality reinforcement that we can call as a heuristic reinforcement signal. It also takes the scalar input, the state vector. It is designed under the delayed reinforcement, and also it observes the temporal sequence. That's what I said, state vector. It also observes the temporal sequence. It also observes the temporal sequence from the state vector, and from the primary reinforcements it converts into the heuristic reinforcements, and also it is performed under the delayed reinforcement. It also performed under the delayed reinforcement. So what is the main goal of this one is minimize the cost to go function. The cumulative cost of the action taken over a sequence of steps instead of simply the immediate cost. So it is taking the cost of actions in that particular sequence of step. In that particular sequence of steps, it will take that one. And these certain actions that are taken earlier with the before previous steps, it may give the better determinants of the overall system. That is the main work of the learning system. What is the second component work? Is second component is a learning system. It is to discover the actions which that better actions and also feed them back to the environment. So delayed reinforcement learning is difficult because it is having the two main reasons. Here there is no teacher to provide the desired response at each step, and the delay incurred in the generation of the primary reinforcement signal implies that learning machine must solve the temporal credit assignment. So in credit assignment learning rule, we studied about the credit assignment. Temporal credit assignment means it to learn the task or to perform the task, it is in time by time it is taking some decisions which are the internal decisions are there to complete the task. So depending upon that, what according to the time, which decision will give the task to perform. That is, we can say if it is a game, task is a game means if you have won the game by that particular sequence with the particular time stamp, whatever the decision you took, depending upon that, that sequence is part of this winning game. that we can call as a credit temporal credit assignment. In that temporal credit assignment, for that particular tax particular action also we are giving the credit assignment. Here it is mainly considering the temporal credit assignment. Whenever it is doing the delay, whenever it is doing the delay with the generation of primary enforcement signal, it will solve the temporal credit assignment, which is having the temporal credit assignment is that it is taking and giving, that it is taking and observing, that is taking and observing. This reinforcement learning is closely related to the dynamic programming, which was developed by the Bellman in the context of optimal control theory. So, for the optimal control theory, he proposed one type of programming, that is dynamic programming. It is also related, reinforcement learning is also related to this dynamic programming. What is the dynamic programming means? It provides the mathematical formulation for the sequential decision making. So, here we are seeking temporal credit assignment. After that, it will take the decision which action is having the more credit, which action is having the more credit, that is giving back to the environment. That is the main work of the second component, learning system component work. So, here dynamic programming provides the mathematical formulas for this sequential decision making. So, next type of learning is unsupervised learning. Till now we studied about the second learning paradigm, learning without a teacher. In that also first one is the reinforcement learning or neurodynamic programming. In this it is using the it is related to the dynamic programming, which is till now we studied. What is the main work of dynamic programming is, it is giving the mathematical formulation to take the sequence of decision steps, So, here it is having the main components, critic and learning. It is also considered the temporal credit assignment. Whenever it is doing the delay for the generation of primary enforcement, what is the credit work is observing that one, and from this primary reinforcement generating the heuristic reinforcement. This is given to the second component, learning system. It takes the input from the environment and also from the critic, and it discovers the better actions which are give the better performance to the overall system, that is giving back to the environment. Like that it will continue its learning. So that is the first one, reinforcement learning and neurodynamic learning. In that, learning without a teacher, second one is, the second type of learning is unsupervised learning. This one is, we can also called as the self-organized learning. Here in this, there is no teacher and critic. There is no teacher and critic to oversee the learning process. Here, main thing is, provision is made for task-independent measure of quality of representation that the network is required to learn. And the free parameters of the network are optimized with respect to that measure. Here it is a provision is made. Provision is there to find the quality of representation. Depending upon that measure, it optimizes the free parameters. Once the network has become tuned, that means once the network is learned from the input, it can have the ability to represent the encoding features of the input and also create the new class automatically. It has the ability to encode the features of the input and also to create the new classes automatically. Here it is using the concept of competitive learning rule that are already we studied about the competitive learning rule. In this, it is generally a two-layer network. In that competitive learning rule, one neuron will respond actively for the given input features. That rule here we are also using. So, and also it operates on the strategy of winners takes all. That means any one output neuron only active at a time according to the whatever the input features are given to that system. So, that concept is using in the unsupervised learning. So, this is about a second paradigm, learning without a teacher. Two concepts are there, reinforcement learning and unsupervised learning. In reinforcement learning, two components are it is using mainly critic and learning system. Here it is not using the critic or teacher or anything. Here simply learning system is there. It is using the rule of competitive learning and strategy of winners all. Winners takes all. So that strategy it uses to learn that one. This is about the learning without a teacher. By this I am concluding this video. Thank you. We'll meet in the next video.